Everything you thought you knew about traditional Irish dancing is about to go out the window. Check this out.
This show is unbelievable. It's called Airborne. It's an Irish rock experience that features one young Aussie who's beaten us Irish at our own game. He's unbelievable. He's so good, he could be from County Wicklow himself. Liam Costello has won the World Irish Dance Championships 3 times and he's just 19 years old.
Wow.
And he joins us now in the studio. Liam, you are awesome. What a pleasure to speak to you.
Thank you. This
is great. It's great for Irish dancing. It's great for traditions. Everyone knows Michael Flatley. He was 17 when he won the World Championships. You've won 3 of them. How long have you been competing internationally?
I've been competing internationally since I was around 11 years old, but I've been dancing since I was 5 or 6, so it's been a long journey, but it's been a good one.
So you've just won a 3rd World Championship. When was the first... How old were you the first time?
I was 16. I won it in 2018 when I was in Glasgow, so it was right before COVID hit. I won 2 consecutively, then COVID hit, and then I won the 3rd one this year.
Now, you have Irish heritage going back of several generations. Mm. What's it like when a non-Irish citizen wins the Irish World Championship, Irish Dancing World Championship?
Winning the Worlds is fine when you're non-Irish heritage, really, because it's such a big community from all over the world. Mm. Everyone just comes together for this event, and it's really special to have everyone in the room when you've worked so hard for something for so long.
Yeah, I think it's great. What was it that got you into Irish dance? It was compulsory for me to do Irish dancing in school, you know, and at the time I didn't particularly like it, but I really appreciate it now and its tradition and the stories behind it. What got you into Irish dancing? Because you could have picked any style.
Yeah, so when I was 5, my parents put me in jazz dance classes, and my school has an end of year dance concert, so at the end of year concert, they had a video and I watched the Irish dancing section and I instantly fell in love with the rhythms, the sounds, the jumping, everything. So over the summer school holidays, I sat and I just watched the video on repeat and was skipping around my living room. And then as soon as classes started back up, I joined straight away.
Oh, what does it feel like when you... I mean, some of those moves and the music that we just saw in Airborne, you know, what does it feel like when you're with a whole heap of other people on stage or even just yourself and you're just in that moment?
Oh, it's amazing. Like, especially competing on your own or just dancing on your own, it's such an exhilarating feeling being able to just fly across the stage and then being able to perform in a group like Airborne. It's just really special to have everyone come together and just... dance it out together.
So cool.
It really is unbelievable. Tell us about Airborne, because I've seen the show before. At one stage, I was trying to be in it. I'm not going to lie. And I know Pete Murray, who's the singer in it, but Peter Anderson, tell us what audiences can expect from Airborne.
So Airborne is an Irish dancing show that is trying to revolutionise Irish dance and bring it into the 21st century by having other styles such as ballroom and tap and just really trying to bring it into the 21st century and make it more engaging for the audience and making it a whole experience with a live 6-piece band and everything.
When you were doing it in primary school, Tristan, were you allowed to use your arms?
Because no, you weren't at all.
This is the revolutionary part of the new generation of Irish dancing.
But it's all intertwined. Like, the Irish dancing is so important, the history behind it and when you could do it. So is the music, so are the stories. Mm. And this is a great way to get people connected to the heritage behind it and show it for a new generation in different eyes. I think it's so, so important. It starts next week. But it's going to start right now in here.
Yes.
You're going to give us a little demo, aren't
you? Yeah, sure.
Fantastic.
Sweet.
Right, get it going, because no one wants to see me Irish dancing. Here's Liam Costello.
Did you want to hit...
No, I'm terrible. I tell you, I won't sell any tickets. Airborne is touring nationally, and it's starting in Melbourne next Friday. Make sure you head to the address on the screens for tickets, and we'll get another taste of the show when we meet the rest of the cast next week. This is awesome. Liam's going to take it away from us. Here you go, mate.